And it was such such an emotional moment. Before we got off the field, and everybody was happy. I remember that, but lots of tears in the dressing room. And there were lots of tears, and there were lots of people, so emotional. I'd had big days, but this didn't come any bigger than this.
5 de febrero de 1972, Hereford, centro de Inglaterra. Partido de desempate de tercera ronda de la FA Cup. El todopoderoso Newcastle de Malcolm McDonald y Bobby Moncur visita al Hereford United, un modesto equipo de aficionados. Su entrenador jugador era Colin Addison, conocido en España por haber entrenado al Atlético de Madrid, al Cádiz, al Celta y al Badajoz. 37 años después regresa a un lugar emblemático para él, el estadio del Hereford. Allí, en Edgar Street, se jugó un encuentro mítico, para muchos uno de los mejores que se han disputado en los casi 140 años de la FA Cup. Esta es la historia de un partido de leyenda, de un partido que nunca volverá a repetirse.
Psychology, when we got 2-2 up at St James's Park, you know, in front of 40,000 people. The pitch was good, the stadium was excellent, you know. But anyway, as soon as we knew we had a replay coming back here, it was going to be a different game completely. Smaller pitch, not in good condition, very heavy, very wet, we always, you know.
Nobody expected us to beat Newcastle. They came with Malcolm McDonald suggesting that he would maybe score 10 goals against us.
A lot of people thought that Newcastle would come here and win maybe 3, 4, 5 goals.
I think deep down, I think we didn't believe, truthfully, that we could win. And also, the BBC thought the same thing because they sent John Watson, who was a junior reporter, thinking that Match of the Day would have just maybe 20, 30 seconds of the Newcastle-Hereford game. And in the end, it became the number one on the program.
Todo estaba listo. Llegó el día del partido. Y todo el pueblo se volcó con el equipo. El interés por ver el encuentro desbordó la más optimista de las previsiones.
The interest within the city and the country, such a small club going to take on Newcastle United.
And the ground was completely full. People were climbing up the trees. You know, the floodlight pylons of people were climbing up the floodlight pylons. Just unbelievable excitement.
They were very, very close to the pitch. I imagine that the Newcastle players had never played in a situation where fans were so close they could almost reach out and touch them.
Acaba la primera parte con empate a cero después de que los dos equipos tuvieran claras ocasiones para marcar.
At half time, I just felt we'd done so well, we were benefiting. You know, my team talk would have been much easier than the Newcastle manager, Joe Harvey.
They got the 12 years.
Because for obvious reasons, 0-0, conditions, you know, the longer the game goes on, psychologically again, so was another team talk, another motivation talk at half time. Come on, keep going, the future, keep playing, be strong, we can win this game.
El reloj avanzaba y nadie lograba anotar un gol. Hasta que sucedió lo que la gran mayoría no deseaba. Era el minuto 80 del partido.
The goal in Newcastle, I still remember it. Un centro going to Malcolm McDonald. One of the best number nines, one of the best forwards that's ever played in the Premiership in England. And as the cross goes, as the ball's going across the box, and as I turn and look, and Malcolm McDonald's on the far post, the back post, is going to the one person on this pitch that you don't want it to arrive. 1-0, 1-0. Great centre, wonderful header, no complaint.
Three in the penalty area. McDonald coming in, that's it.
El sentimiento de decepción y frustración inundó el estadio.
First thoughts, mine as manager, in all honesty, I thought, that's it, Benito, finished. 8 minutes to go, I think. 8 minutes. 8 or 10 minutes to go. Late in the game, I'm not sure of the time, but late in the second half, we all thought, that's it. I did. Not that we stopped trying, but I just thought, can we come back from this? Can we pick ourselves up? Can we come back from this?
When McDonald scored, obviously everybody thought it's 80 minutes, it's 10 minutes to go. That's probably it. And so the difference for me and the rest of the team was that I then came onto the pitch and I was able to shout to them, come on, you know, we can do this. Come on, guys. I thought to myself, I've got 10 minutes maximum to do something special. If ever I'm going to do something, I have to do it now.
Pero 3 minutos después del duro golpe de McDonald, la ilusión comenzó a asomarse por Edgar Street. Y lo hizo a lo grande, gracias a Ronnie Redford.
Played a little pass, a little give and go, a little one-two, what we say in football, you know. And he came back to him, and I was right behind it, just where you are, just behind your hand, just hit it. And as soon as it left his foot, it was a goal. He knew. He knew, I knew, we all knew. So there's still a goal that's still talked about now, 37 years after. Still talked about in the head even now, and in England, in British football.
Radford. Now Tudor's gone down for Newcastle. Radford again. Oh, what a goal! What a goal! Radford the scorer! Ronnie Radford!
Won the goal of the year, the goal of the month, goal of everything, goal of the century, I think. It was a super goal, lovely goal. Everybody, the kids were there, the kids were around him, the people, the players ran and got hold of him and gave him a hug and a kiss, you know.
But it gave us the chance to have another go. It gave me the chance to have another 30 minutes on the pitch.
They looked absolutely forlorn. They you know, they just... It just looked them. You could see their heads go down. But what I think, what really did them, was the quality of the goal. The quality of the goal.
El partido acaba con empate a uno. La prórroga aguarda a los jugadores. Era el momento de Ricky George.
I can remember that it eventually the ball reached Dudley Tyler, and I was standing on the penalty area with my back to goal, and looking at Dudley, give it to me. He did give it to me. I'm not sure he meant to give it to me. I think he might have had a shot, but he drove it at my feet. And the big surprise for me was that I actually had the space and the time to get the shot in. And I looked up, and it was there. It was in the bottom corner.
George.
I was a 12-year-old ball boy at Hereford United. When Ricky George scored his goal, I ran onto the pitch, like many other young children at the day. I was one of the first to jump off. I jumped off the Newcastle dugout, which we all crowded around Ricky George.
Because my career really had been disappointing. But the goal, I knew, of course, it's the most famous goal I'm ever going to score. And it's probably the only goal that's ever going to be on television.
They say, that afternoon, the two goals that we scored, you could hear the other side of the city. We've done it. We've done the hard part. We've come from 1-0 down, got to 1-1, got our noses in front, 2-1. This is for us now. We don't throw this away now. We don't lose this now. And that's the way it's turned out to be. Yeah.
He must blow any second.
Han pasado casi 40 años y el recuerdo de aquel partido, de aquella victoria, aún sigue emocionando a Colin Addison.
Oh, just sorry. Thank you.
I think that says it all. I think we've done it. And I remember going in, as you go in the dressing room, there's a little treatment room, physio. And I remember going in there on my own and crying. And then back in the dressing room, then I was okay, and I was over it, and celebrated with the players with some champagne and some beer, and everybody came in. Never experienced anything like that. It was really, 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 really good at you, really, for a lot of us, because we knew we might not do anything like that again. And you know, I had some good days with Nottingham Forest, with Arsenal, with Sheffield, and other cup runs, but nothing like this to beat Newcastle.
Ocurrió en Hereford un 5 de febrero de 1972, un lugar y una fecha donde siempre permanecerá una parte de quien vivió un día irrepetible.